Hello, welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on extracting financial management journals using data management. This demonstration was created using a desktop recording application. Starting in data management, select the Setup tab. First, I'll add a custom target application. A custom target application enables you to extract data from financial management and then export data into a flat file. For type, select Custom Application, then click OK. In the Application Details section, enter an application name. On the Dimension Details tab, add a row for each dimension you want to export. For each row, enter a dimension name that corresponds to a consolidation dimension. The target dimension class is determined by the dimension type. The data table column name contains the name of the column in the data management staging table. When you export, data is written to the file based on a predefined order, starting with account, then entity, and then user-defined dimensions. Let's move on to application options. To make sure data management creates an output data file for the custom target application, set the Enable Export to File option to Yes. A file will be created in the Data Management Outbox folder of your server. Next, I'll define an import format. Import formats determine which data columns are extracted from the source system and how they are stored in data management staging tables. The name identifies the import format when you assign it to other configurations such as location. Descriptions are optional. Set the source type to EPM and select your source application. For target type, select EPM. Then, select the custom target application you defined. Drill URLs are not required for this integration. Verify and save your entries. This is where you define the relationship between your source dimensions and target columns of your custom application. For each dimension, add a row. You can choose to load data into a specific member by specifying a default in the expression text box. Next, I'll add a location. The location links the import format to the source and target systems. Enter a name. Descriptions are optional. Then, select the import format you defined. The source and target systems are selected for you. Verify and save your entries. Let's talk about period mappings. Period mappings are used to match period formats between the source and target system. Global mappings are shared by applications in your EPM system. I'll add specific source and target mappings. In this example, to ensure I extract financial management journals using the quarter one period mapping, I added an explicit period mapping on the source mapping tab. Let's create data load mappings. Make sure you select the location you defined and the period you'll be importing from. You use data load mappings to derive the target members for each dimension based on source values. You must create a mapping for each dimension you want to export. Options available in the dimension drop-down list depend on the dimensions you configured in your import format. In this example, all source and target dimensions are mapped without modifications using the like mapping type. Let's create our data load rule. You run data load rules to push data into target applications and export them to a flat file. First, verify that you have the correct location and POV selected. Enter a data load rule name. Descriptions are optional. Select your category and period mapping type. You can filter the data you want to import using source filters. In this example, I added a source filter for each dimension I'm using to define the data to extract. I included a filter condition that allows me to pull elimination journals from the source application. In source parameters, set the extract type to journal. Click the target options tab. Verify that the export to file option is enabled. When you execute the data load rule, make sure import from source and export to target are selected and verify your period selections. The status column displays the current state of the import and export process. Click refresh until you see a check mark. I'll navigate to the workbench to show you the exported journal. The data is staged in data management. Now, I'll download the data file from the process details page. Locate your process and scroll until you see the output file column. Click the download link. I'll save my file to local folder. The exported data file is displayed. The extracted file contents are displayed. In this tutorial, you saw how to extract financial management journals using data management. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.